The internet sex police, Polygon, have just released a news article about the Oculus Rift. Virtual reality porn already exists, writes Ben Kuchera, and Oculus isn't interested in stopping it. I'm sure that you're already wringing your hands about the well-being of America's children. While not factually inaccurate, this style of headline is something that I'd more expect on an environmentally concerned website, speaking about something like, say, fracking. This is the language of concern. Something's already happening, and it might spread. Meanwhile, the gatekeeper, the people who could stop it, aren't even interested in doing so. Quite the ominous narrative, regardless of the subject matter or your personal opinions. Maybe there's something to this, though. Check out that cleavage in the advert next to this piece. Sexual content really is spreading unstopped. Now, you might say that this ad is intended for women, to sell them clothing, but I think my boner is proof that intent isn't magic. Ben wrote that the answer about the Oculus being open came about when people asked about the possibility of pornography on the Oculus Rift. That is technically true, but there is a bit of spin there for sure. Let's look at the source he's using. Variety's headline is simply, Oculus has no plans to block virtual reality porn. Out of context, this title could seem a bit odd, but the second paragraph of the piece explains that they were explicitly asked whether they would be blocking it or not. The title makes sense given that context. They're simply reporting what happened. Oculus were asked, will you block this? Oculus said no. There's the headline. Ben's piece doesn't really make it look like that. He makes it seem like there's an unstoppable march of pornography that Oculus is complicit in. I'm not saying there'd be anything wrong with that, I'm just trying to analyze how this is being portrayed. Maybe you disagree with me, but I think there's a significant difference between saying they were asked if they'd block it and they say no and they explained why not, and being asked, can we do porn on it, and them saying, yeah. And on top of that, Ben's making it really sound like a downside, like being open lets you get all this cool experimental stuff, but then the downside is porn, because that's what apparently will make people uncomfortable. I'd go ahead and say that absolutely anything will make some people uncomfortable. It is absolutely not as black and white as this. I do not think there is a clear line between comfortable and uncomfortable content, and I certainly don't think experimental things are on one side and pornography is on the other. And yet, that's what this news article seems to be suggesting. Content some people may find uncomfortable. Well, that is absolutely anything. Why make that distinction if you aren't making the point it seems to be making? Overall, I'm just really surprised at the angle Ben decided to take with this. Why is he being kind of negative when it has implications for improving the ethical standards of his profession? Games journalists can now avoid conflicts of interest by merely simulating sex with their subjects. But, as usual, that's just another one of my harmful opinions. One little last thing. Ben wrote, adult entertainment will find its way to do the device. Look, buddy, Ben, when you put porn on something, your hardware isn't getting fucked.